You tackled a whole new topic with this Eyes Wide Open. This is his new book, Eyes Wide Open, Going Behind the Environmental Headlines. And Paul, tell us a little bit about how you decided to delve into this and why.
Well, I was living out in the country, and one day I noticed a dead bee on my driveway. And the next day there was a different one in a different place. And then there were more, and it kept going and kept going. So the book really began with the act of noticing. And the interesting thing is you start on something small, like a tiny dead bee in your palm, and you're very quickly into something big: population, development, agriculture, pesticides. And that's really how it happened. It also went back to something I remember from high school. At that point, it wasn't the environment, it was Vietnam. That was the story of the century, it seemed. And people were, my fellow students were graduating, and many of them, some of them going off to Vietnam. And yet the topic wasn't in our textbooks. It wasn't in the classroom. It wasn't on the pages of our school newspaper, where our editorials talked about the importance of school spirit and attendance at pep rallies. And so there was a total disconnect between the classroom and the wider world. And I saw that happening today. And so the book was my attempt to bridge that gap.
So you really saw like a shortage in this area, and you wanted to kind of canvas the whole landscape then.
Absolutely. And I wanted to talk to older kids who are, and adults as well, who are old enough to understand how the world really works. I had thought I would be a history teacher, actually. And then my first book was bought, and I never looked back toward education as a career. But I've written quite a few books over the years for the teacher I didn't become. And this is the latest of them. I would have loved using this book because it really looks at the real world and tries to give readers a lot of different lenses to comprehend it.
Now, you were talking to me, we were talking earlier about you're getting a lot of questions now that you're out promoting the book, that you're getting a lot of questions from people basically about what they can do. And you feel like there are a lot of things that individuals can do. Some things that maybe if you could talk a little bit about what you see, where people can jump in and need to jump in.
Absolutely. The first thing I think we can all do is educate ourselves, and this includes adults. I've discovered that adults aren't up on the facts of life, these facts of life, any more than teenagers are. And I put myself in that category. When I started the book, I started from a place of ignorance. In many cases, I learned a ton, despite the fact this information is so basic to our lifestyles. So that's the first thing. Well, there's a lot one can do. Private acts, public acts. Private acts have a great benefit. You can do them today. You don't need to get a bill through Congress. And it feels great to align your actions with your beliefs. And action tends to beget action. So you're then inspired to make other changes. So that's a great thing. That could be cutting back on meat. It's been said that that's the biggest impact you could have, because meat these days is grown from feed that is so drenched in fossil fuels that meat represents a very concentrated dose of greenhouse gases. At the end of the book, after writing the book, I couldn't take it anymore. I gave up meat.